Hi, it's Alaska Granny. Have you thought about your risk to nuclear fallout or radiation poisoning? Well, if you have ever heard of the Natural Resources Defense Council, they have a map on their website that shows you all of the places in the United States that have nuclear facilities and the possibility then of you being a downwinder, or if something happens there, that you could be exposed to radiation poisoning. And if you look at just the year 2011, they had shutdowns in Maryland, two of them in Virginia, Nebraska, and Alabama because of hurricanes, floods, and tornadoes. Did you know that the Center for Disease Control recommends that you have a potassium iodide in your emergency supplies, and the FDA cleared it for you to have on hand over the counter in 2001, and they've been recommending it also since 2011. Did you even know that? It came as a surprise to me. And the thing about radiation poisoning is that the radiation goes into your thyroid, and well, it gets in all your body, but it damages your thyroid. So if you take a potassium iodide tablet, when the risk is there, not like you wouldn't ever take it unless you were at immediate risk. But then this pill has an iodide salt that fills your thyroid, so then the bad chemicals can't get into your thyroid, and that can protect your health. And the younger you are, the more you can be harmed from this. Infants are the most at risk, and people over 40 are less at risk. But it's something that if you are concerned with your family, you need to be sure that you read the dosage and talk to your doctor if you have infants or you're pregnant or you're a nursing or breastfeeding mother. So the one that we chose for our family is the Iosat, and it comes in a 14-day packet. You would never take more than one every 24 hours, and you would only use this if you were in a direct threat of being having radiation poisoning in your area. We live in the West Coast, so when we heard about Fukushima, we of course were greatly concerned with the winds that were blowing towards us and the radiation that might be coming. Well, you couldn't get this stuff for any price. It was completely sold out and it was totally unavailable. So I figure if overnight, just like that, I might need something like this, I can get a packet of this online for like $7, which they were not even available before. And if you look on the back, these don't even expire until 2017. And if you read the current information about prescription drugs and over-the-counter drugs, they're saying that the actual expiration date is far longer, that that's just a recommendation that the drug companies put, and basically it's helping them to sell more drugs. Do the research for yourself. See what you think about if storing potassium iodide is a medication that you're concerned with for your family's safety. And leave a comment on what you think about the risks and dangers of nuclear fallout. And please subscribe to the Alaska Granny channel. Have a wonderful day.